There is always a traditional belief among Tamils that it was Shiva who preached Vedam, and he did it sitting under Kallala tree, which is a mountain variety of banyan tree. When I researched about Kala Bhairava aspect of Shiva, I happened to understand Shiva in complete perspective and discovered that Shiva was a hunter, which means Vedan in Tamil. It was very obvious then to hypothesize that Vedam was called so as it was preached by Vedan, the hunter. Further research revealed to me that Vedam originally meant splitting, as it should when Rigveda was created, and later on took the connotation meaning signs. When Mr. Marek Zelem of Slovakia watched my video on Kala Bhairava, he was thrilled by my inference and wrote to me that Veda means signs in Slovakian language. That was the beginning, and we had lots of correspondence which amazed me on the connection between Tamil language and culture and Slovakian language and culture, which I hitherto did not know. Mr. Marek Zelem is an engineer in information technology stream. Mr. Marek Zelem was deeply interested in Tamil, and I thought that he would do well if he knows about Tamil, their land and customs, and hence requested him to come to Tamil Nadu. Thus, he was here recently and spent a fortnight with me.
And after I read this book, I wanted to, because from this book I had the clear notion that, okay, Tamils are the oldest nation on the world, Tamil culture is the oldest culture of the world, and every culture evolved from this Tamil culture. I wanted to know, does anybody else say the same thing? So I searched the internet. I found some claims and some counterclaims. Finally, I found Pandian videos. It was quite enlightening, I would say, because even this view of Asivaram, this was, I never thought of that this way. Pandian, this view that you presented, this was amazing. This was, I was watching the videos one by one, and this is it, this is how it is logical, this is how, this is reality. I even wonder why we don't all understand that this is reality, because this is so logical. So I watched every video, and finally I got to the video of this Kala Bhairava corrected version, when there was this claim. They started our communication, and since Pandian invited me, and this was like for me life's opportunity that don't repeat itself. One in a lifetime that somebody offer you something and you know that you take it or you lose it forever. So I took the opportunity and I'm here.
I took him around Tamil Nadu and showed him a variety of places. Together, we discovered amazing ancient connection between these two cultures, and it should be known to the world. My revelations in this video would help dig up the true history of the world. In this video, which is the first part of the series I want to bring out, I would just consider a few pivotal words which showcases the ancient connection between these two cultures. This would help locating the true history of the world. The evening that Mr. Marek landed in Chennai, we had a long conversation. He asked me about the word Kulam, that is Kula. I told him that it means a society of people, and Gurukulam, that is Gurukula, means a community of students and a teacher called Guru in Tamil. He then told me that in Slovak, Skola means school, and he also told me that the English word school originated from Skola of Slovak. He meant that Tamil Kula became Skola in Slovak, which became school in English. This clearly shows that the European words did not actually originate from Latin, despite the influence of Latin in Europe due to early Christianity. The only connection between Latin and the Western Slavic languages is a script, which is a modification of the Latin script. However, both Slovak and Latin were influenced by Tamil, and the influence of Tamil on Slovak being forgotten, which led to the belief that European languages originated from Latin. In fact, there is the triangular relationship between Tamil, Latin and Slovak. From this discussion, we come to know that Slovak should have been the root of the East European languages, against the prevalent notion that all European languages originated from Greek and Latin. Do we have proof? Yes, we have. Mr. Marek Zelem then asked me to say a Tamil word, which means word. I told him Vartai. He then asked me for another Tamil word, meaning word. I then told him Sol. He then told me that Slovakia was named after the Tamil word Sol. It is in the consciousness of the Slavs that the language was named after a word, meaning word. He told me that the word Sol became slow, and I agreed readily that such deformation is quite a reality. He said even though their nation is called Slovakia, it should have been called Slovenia, according to Dr. Ciril Hromnik, who splits the word Sloveni as slow plus veni, where slow means word of praise, which evolved from sol, meaning word in Tamil, and veni means stack of hair in Tamil, which actually means Shiva. Hence, according to him, Sloveni means worshipping Shiva, and Slovenia means the land of people worshipping Shiva, a word of Tamil origin. Shiva being the common ancient god of humanity, it could well be a possibility. In fact, if there is no other contending idea, this could be the obvious etymological origin of the name Sloveni. However, there is a contention to this etymology arising from Tamil perspective. We would soon see it. Moreover, the national god of Babylonia was Marduk, who was nothing but Muruga, the god of the warrior people called Sumerians. This is another challenge to Sloveni etymology surrounding Shiva. Mr. Marek Zelem also told me, for all the languages of Slavic nations, namely Slovakia, Czech Republic, Bosnia, Serbia, Poland, Slovenia, Belarus, Russia, Ukraine, Bulgaria, Macedonia, Croatia, and Montenegro, Slovak is the central language, both geographically and linguistically. Slovaks can understand other Slavic languages more easily than other Slavic nations understand each other. This is consistent with the fact that very names Slavic and Slovak are closely related. It is also consistent with the written chronicles of Czech and primary chronicle of Kievan Rus. They both claim that their nations originated from Slovaks, although this fact is not popularly known. Hence, through Marek Zelem, I came to know that Slovakia is the root language and not Sloveni. Moreover, while Sloveni could be called after Shiva, Slovakia obviously can't be named after Shiva or understood otherwise. But if I provide a consistent etymological origin of both Slovakia and Sloveni, then that shall form the correct root of these names. The etymology of the word Sloveni is as in the following: Solvai plus ni, Slovaini, Sloveni, Sloveni. Ni means you, and Solvai literally means word of mouth, but means contextually as would speak. Thus, Sloveni means you would speak, and hence Slovenia shall be taken to mean the land that speaks. We shall now consider Slovakia. Sol plus vakyam, Slovakiam, Slovakia. Sol means word and vakyam means sentence. It is a straightforward, fault-free etymology of Slovakia. Hence, Slovakia literally means sentence of words and contextually as spoken language. Hence, the nation Slovakia should have been called as it was the land that heard spoken language. Thus, we could explain the name origin of both these countries under a single consistent theme. Not only this, there is a fundamentally more important meaning to this. Consider the following two facts. Slovak is the root language. It is named after human speech. These two facts together mean something extraordinary. What is it? Dr. Ciril Hromnik says that they might have moved to Slovakian region some 5,000 years ago. He clearly says that they were not present in these areas during Ice Age. Hence, prior to 4000 BC, their land was not inhabited by humans of modern era, that is, the present era, that is, the era of Homo sapiens. That means Slovaks would have been the first humans to move to this region in the present era. Let us remember that etymologically Slovakia means spoken language. Suppose human migration happens to a land where no humans inhabited previously, it is more likely that land would be called the land that heard human sound or spoken language. There is simply no other reason why a land should be called as spoken language. It has to be the land, among the land surrounding it, where human sound was first heard. Do I have another example to substantiate it? Yes, I do. The nation called Nepal on the Himalayan mountain was called so with the meaning human sound. Na means tongue and paluk means articulate. Na plus paluk, Napal, Nepal, which literally means articulation of tongue and contextually means the land that speaks itself. And that's exactly how the Nepalese think that their land got its name. Nepal was the first mountain region in that area which heard human sound. And that's the reason Nepal got its name. The people who left mountain abode in Lemuria due to flooding might have moved to this mountain region first among other such nearby mountain regions. Similarly, Slovakia was the first land occupied by humans in Eastern Europe, and hence Slovak was the root language of Eastern Europe from which all its daughter languages emerged. The Slovakians say that they should have moved from Babylonia to their present whereabouts. But they are clueless about the relation of their language to Tamil except a trade connection that goes back to 3000 BC. However, it is the very Babylonia that bridges the Slavic people with the Tamil. How? The Bible says that all people spoke one language when Babylonian tower was being built. What was that language? It was Tamil. The Babylonians spoke Tamil even though Tamil was not named so at the time, as it was the only language of the world. Later on, when they spread to other regions, the other languages emerged. To realize the fact that Tamil was the language of Babylonians, we would see now how the word Babylon evolved. Y plus L, Yl, Vavel, Babel. Y, which literally means mouth, connotes here as residing place. Yl means God. Hence, Babel means the residence of the God. Y connotes as residence, as a cave looks like an open mouth, which was ancient man's residence. That's how residence was called Y. Hence, Babel is the residence of God, and Babylon is the God who resides in Babel. Hence, Babel and Babylon are indisputably Tamil words. Hence, when Slovaks migrated to Slovakia from Babylon, they spoke Tamil, but Tamil was not named so at that time. Hence, they named that land spoken language, as spoken language was first heard in that region, as other regions of Europe were uninhabited by humans. That's how their land got the name Slovakia. So far, we have seen that Slovakian researchers themselves think that their language was named after Tamil words, and they also think that the language could be the root language of Eastern Europe. I have given explanation as to how Slovak could be the root language based on the way their land was named. I would further discuss two words that prove the ancient connection between Tamils and Slovaks. Husband is called manjal in Slovak. Manjal in Tamil means turmeric. From the very ancient times, when a Tamil man ties turmeric around the neck of a woman, she becomes his wife, and the one who ties turmeric becomes her husband. Husband gives manjal to woman and thus makes her a legitimate wife. This custom is still followed in Tamil Nadu, and it dates back to several millennia, even 10 millennia. The fact that Slovaks call husband as manjal proves the fact that Slovaks were originally Tamils. The Slavs were forcibly converted to Christianity. They were originally pagan worshippers. Pagan worship was an ancient Tamil worship, which continues in the name of Hinduism even today, even though Tamils were never Hindus, and Hinduism was forced on to Tamils by some peculiar means. The peculiarity is that Hinduism was made out of Tamil gods with fictional stories which replaced the actual history of the gods. I would publish the colossal merits of the pagan worship of Tamils by a short video soon. Coming back to our discussion, the ancient pagan Slovaks worshipped their gods in temples called Kostol. That's the reason they don't call their church as church. They call their Christian churches as Kostol. It is actually a deformed Tamil word. In Tamil, temple is called Koil. Here, Ko means king and Il means residence. Tamil temple is called residence of the king. Ancient kings of Tamils were Siddha, who became gods after attaining Nirvana. That's how the residence of the king became the residence of the god. In fact, most of the ancient temples of today were built in places where Siddha lived earlier and from where they ruled the people. The Siddha never conquered any land to become kings. As Siddha means wisdom, Siddha were the knowledgeable people, and hence they became kings by default. Their rule was not dynastic, And whichever Siddha became very popular because of his contribution, that Siddha became the king, and the network of Siddha who lived all through the land on hill caves took care of the respective regional administrations of the nation. The word place is called Thalam in Tamil. Hence, the place where kings lived is called Ko plus Thalam, Kothalam, Kothal, Kostal, Kostol. That is how the Slovakian word Kostol evolved, and it reflects ancient connection of Slovaks with Tamil, who were one and the same people several thousand years ago. We would deliberate on this matter further. The Siddha ruling Tamil lands existed more than 3,000 years ago. After this period, dynastic rule appeared in Indian subcontinent, which is not Siddha-based. Hence, the word Koyil evolved during the time the Siddha were kings of Tamil lands. Kostol means place of king, and Koyil means the residence of king. And these are two different words with the same meaning. Kostol should have evolved more than 3,000 years ago, and this word connects ancient Tamil culture with that of the Slovaks. When I was on tour with Mr. Marek Zelem, Mr. Sudan of Pune called me by phone. I just told him about Marek Zelem, and he was very thrilled. The very next day, he sent a link regarding Dr.Ciril, Hromnik, the content of which really stunned me. Dr.Ciril, Hromnik categorically states that Indo-European languages did not originate from Sanskrit, contrary to the popular belief. I am reading out his own words, and his speech is displayed here. I will just quote from Socrates, where he says, "When we discuss the questions of Ethiopia, we can't decide whether we are talking about Indians or about Ethiopians. Because, indeed, it is so that ancient India and Ethiopia are basically one country, one civilization. However, for those of us who are hot on the theory of Indo-Europeanism, that our languages are Indo-European, this doesn't seem hold water because we perceive India as Sanskritic language speaking. And the tendency is to believe that Sanskrit is the oldest language on earth, which is not true because Sanskrit does not go further than something like 1400 or 1500 BC. Yet, India was by the time highly, highly civilized and had already a pantheon of 1008 gods. And this is a major problem in our studies of ancient history, that people tend to think that you should study Sanskrit in order to understand the oldest history, which is not true." These are the words from a European, which pulverizes the myth that Sanskrit is the oldest language and the myth that Sanskrit is being the mother of Indo-European languages. Sanskrit being the mother of Indo-European languages was mooted by Carl Wilhelm Friedrich Schlegel and consolidated by Max Müller. Both were Germans. When the European white race came to India for trade, they encountered a white race in India called Brahmins. These Brahmins were the custodians of Sanskrit language and a large corpus of Sanskrit literature of immense worth. Obviously, a white race would not have originated from India, which is a tropical country, and hence they thought that the Brahmins brought Sanskrit to India along with the great stuff in the Sanskrit literature. With a generally prevailing notion that Vedas were very ancient, and the Vedas being written in Sanskrit, they believed that Sanskrit was the mother of all languages, including the so-called Indo-European languages. This very term was coined because of the idea that Sanskrit was the root of European languages. The identification of many European words as words of Sanskrit origin strengthened this faulty concept. Unfortunately, these early Europeans did not know the true history of India and the connection of Max Müller with the Brahma Samaj, which played the pivotal role in distorting the true history through Max Müller. The Nordic people identified themselves with the Brahmins as belonging to the same race and hence felt a sense of pride because of the colossal Sanskrit literature, and they called themselves as Aryans, as Brahmins are called Aryans in India. That's how Hitler declared himself as Aryan, and his Aryan supremacy idea followed from Max Müller, who was a German himself. That's how the Nordic people called themselves as Aryan, even though they were not known as Aryan race prior to the rendezvous with the Indians. Unfortunately, it was a colossal nonsense to think that Sanskrit and Sanskrit literature belonged to Brahmins. An object that is presently in the hands of a person need not belong to him. It could have come to him through so many means. This is where Max Muller went wrong. Sanskrit is not the root language, and it was a refined language from Prakrit, which belonged to pre-Aryan India. Sanskrit itself landed on the laps of Brahmins because of Mahayana Buddhism, which is their version of Buddhism, and Sanskrit actually belonged to the original Buddhists, so branded as Hinayana Buddhism, which the Brahmins destroyed. Hence, neither Sanskrit nor its literature belonged to Brahmins of India, even though majority of the literature were translated into Sanskrit by these Brahmins during Gupta period, that is, about 5th century AD. Hence, Sanskrit language never existed prior to Buddha, and it was written using Tamil Brahmi, as it was actually a North Indian version of Tamil. Thus, I categorically state that Sanskrit never existed prior to 500 BC. Dr.Ciril, the Slovak researcher, places the earliest time of the existence of Sanskrit to 1500 BC and definitely not beyond. Thus, the myth regarding Sanskrit has been shattered by Dr.Ciril, a European himself. He further categorically says that Tamil is the oldest language, which shall imply that Sanskrit itself should have originated from Tamil, and that is the truth and reality. I am reading out his own words, which is displayed here. And Tamil is the oldest language, and Tamil is the richest language, and in Tamil, you can detect the oldest references through the world as far back as 3000 BC or before. These are the words from a European researcher who learned Hindi and Tamil. This is what I have been saying all along. Tamil words are like time capsule which retain the true history of the world. This is the first video in the series detailing the connection between Tamil and Slavic languages. During the fortnight that Mr. Marek Zelem was here, we have uncovered more than 50 Slovakian words of Tamil origin. We both have decided to study Tamil-Slovakian connection further. This is very important as Slovak is the root language of Eastern Europe. Soon I would publish more videos on the connection between Slovakia and Tamil Nadu. Based on the preliminary studies I have already done on languages like Russian, I can say without error that Tamil is the mother of Slavic languages. This statement of mine would be proved beyond doubt in the days to come. On the day that Mr. Marek Zelem departed from Tamil Nadu, I took him to the airport in my car. On the way, he said that they are planning to name his expected second son as Swarad. He asked me for the etymological origin of the word Swarad. I asked him for the tentative meaning of the word so that I shall guess its etymological origin. He said that its meaning is united. I then readily and immediately provided the etymological interpretation of that word. Just like Kula of Tamil became Skola of Slovak, the Tamil original of Swarad should have been Orad. Swarad, Orad, Orad. This word should be split as Orad, Or plus Rad, Or plus Rath, Or plus Ratham, Ore plus Ratham. Or or Ore means one, and Ratham means blood in Tamil. Hence, Orad, that is Ore Ratham, means people of the same blood, and thus united. We both were thrilled by its meaning. I told him that our cultures are united by the same blood. With that note, I bid farewell to him and decided to continue our friendship and research further for the welfare of humanity. For not only that Tamils and Slavs are connected by the same blood, the entire world is united by one blood and one basic gene. That gene was most probably that of Virumandi of Madurai. If the world realizes this basic fact, a dawn of new era, an era of peace and prosperity would blossom in the world, and I am very hopeful of it.